I touch your lips and all at once the sparks go flying. Those devil lips that know so well the art of lying. And though I see the danger still, the flames grow higher. I know I must surrender to your kiss of fire.
This process is really a cross between creation and destruction. Let it go too far, you've destroyed. Put it together in some terrific way, you've created. It's kind of exciting.
Without your kiss of fire, I can't resist you.
My work was always very beautiful, nature-based images, very serene. But now, with everything in the world that's going on, I felt it needed a little more edginess to it. So I started to play with gunpowder and burn everything. And it's an amazing process because it's all about chance. You can control just a little bit, and then the rest you work with. After you've burned and everything is all kind of chaotic, you restructure it. You put it together so you make another universe. It gives it that sense of destruction and creation together, which is what I think nature is all about. After I do the explosions, that's just the beginning. I build many layers. So the gunpowder is combined with woodblock, with acrylic, chalk, inks, layers of Japanese paper with gunpowder stains on them, and collage. And I'll put them all together, and the many layers tell you something mysterious. You couldn't think of it on your own. It comes up as the process unfolds.
I can't resist you. What good is that trying?
The process is a narrative about diminishing boundaries. So there's no boundaries anymore. Everything kind of flows into everything else. Everything oscillates back and forth. You don't have a distinction between the imagery, the ground, and the boundaries are blurred, as in life.
Love me tonight, let the devil take tomorrow.
You're an alchemist. Now, instead of making gold, you're making something from all of these processes that turn into a new universe.
The kiss of fire. Ah, burn me.